see you or your pet Vulcan in here again, human.
That's right. Keep walking, Captain Krag.
I believe he's getting that chair to hit you with. Oh, we should go. Captain, in my time as your first officer, I have seen you enter numerous altercations, but I have yet to see you win one.
What about that Nausicaan at X2? He went down like a sack of potatoes.
He injured his back lifting you over his head.
That counts.
Perhaps you should, as the Earth saying goes, pick upon someone of your own stature.
Why would I fight someone I knew I could beat? That's cowardly. And hey, I left those two guys for you because I thought Vulcans were supposed to be strong.
Strength is relative, but two Klingon warriors might be a better match for a Vulcan male.
Hey, don't sell yourself short. That one guy is going to be walking funny for a few days.
He would not listen to reason. And he also bit me.
Yeah, Klingons do that. I'll take a look at it when we get back to Aurora.
Ooh, that looks like it smarts.
Pain is a state of mind.
Maybe, but infection isn't. And Klingons aren't known for dental hygiene. We've got antibiotics in here somewhere.
I can manage.
Okay, I'm sorry. But Krag and his crew have been throwing their weight around ever since they showed up in this sector. And it was time somebody stood up to them.
And you felt that somebody should be the two of us.
That's the beauty of it. The two women crew of a cargo hauler against the warriors of a Klingon battlecruiser. All we had to do was hold our own, and they'd be so humiliated they'd have to leave the sector.
Captain, you employ the most abstruse form of logic.
Goodnight, Tling. Abstruse? Where does she get these words? Tling? Tling!
Captain, help me.
Tling! What happened? What's wrong? Tling?
Well, I'm no doctor, but it looks like you're the whole package, inside and out.
I shall understand your colloquialism to mean that I am indeed male, and not only in appearance.
See for yourself.
And this label was on the vial when you bought it?
It must have come unstuck in the cabinet. How was I supposed to know it's set by oxen underneath?
What is this alluramate?
It's a kind of beauty supplement, like vitamins. Or something.
And what exactly is this supplement supposed to do?
Well, not this. I don't want to be a guy.
I do not wish to be a guy either. I will assume you do not know this alluramate's physiologic properties.
No. The guy I bought it from said it was an ancient secret.
Sold in used bioxin vials.
Well, I never took it, did I?
No. I did.
Okay, look, can't we just analyze what's left and see what it's made of?
That would only answer part of the equation. We must know how this alluramate is intended to affect the body before we can understand what went wrong. The logical course of action is to first speak with its creator.
It took some digging, but I found the box I was looking for. Some of this should fit.
And I found your so-called Dr. Smith.
That's him! Wait, Harcourt Fenton Mudd? What kind of name is that?
The name of a notorious criminal and trader in goods of dubious worth and integrity, much like himself, whose last recorded crime in Federation space was to escape from a high-security rehabilitation facility.
But he was in the Xenarian Medical Registry. The government registry. I checked it myself.
Captain, Xenarians require no proof of training or competency to register as a physician, presumably due to the fact that the penalty for medical negligence among Xenarians is typically death at the hands of the patient's surviving family.
Well, doctor or not, we have to talk to him. I met him back on X2, but that was a while ago.
It appears that he has closed his subnet account. Therefore, we cannot contact him directly, even if that would do any good. His line of work does not generally encourage correspondence with previous customers. From a search of the public merchnet, however, I have deduced that he is currently headed for Stone's Throw Station.
Merchnet doesn't track passengers.
But it does track goods. Xenarians are lax on many things, but not on taxes and duties. A crate containing one denobulin chemical synthesizer, various bulk biochemicals, and a container of bioxin vials is en route to Stone's Throw Station, registered to a Leo Walsh, one of Mr. Mudd's known aliases. Stone's Throw is just a week's journey from here, at maximum warp for Aurora.
Well, it would be if her impulse engine wasn't in a million pieces. You know I've been overhauling it.
Perhaps less time spent brawling in bars would hasten its repair.
Well, if you want to hasten getting out of here, you're going to have to help me.
You have never asked before.
It's a first time for everything. In the meantime, there's a bunch of men's stuff in this tote that should probably fit.
Why would you have a box of men's clothing?
I never said you were my first officer. The last one left some stuff behind. I washed it all. Here, there's even stuff to sleep in. And we should both get some sleep. We can tackle the impulse drive a lot better on a little rest.
Safety equipment on the worksite should include radiation-resistant clothing, eye and ear protection, as well as helmets and crushless gloves. Before repairs can commence, it is essential to secure the worksite. Proper signage is recommended, and it is also recommended that access to the worksite be restricted by.
Morning.
I have eaten, but I made breakfast for you so that we may get an early start.
Thanks.
Is the temperature setting too cool for you, Captain?
No, I just... Well, you're a guy now, so I thought I should cover up. I mean, I don't want to brag, but most guys get a load of this and can't keep their hands off.
I can assure you that you are in no danger of that from me.
Well... Sure, but I'll understand if you don't want to help me with the drive today. You know, the two of us, alone back there, in such close quarters.
I shall await you in engineering, and you needn't worry about the close quarters, Captain. Even were I truly male, your considerable human charms would hardly be a match for Vulcan discipline.
Vulcan discipline, huh? Did you turn off the automatic door sensor?
Yes, Captain. The basics of engine repair manual that you sent me suggests that one should secure the work area including placing access doors on manual.
That was good thinking.
Thank you, Captain. Shall we begin?
Let's do it.
You don't wanna, but you just gotta have her now. You know you're a goner, even though she's not your kind of gal. There's something about her you can't put your finger on. Feels so right, something's gotta be wrong. But the only thing you know for sure is you don't wanna, but you just gotta have her now. You know you're a goner, 'cause she just might be your kind of gal. She's got a hook in you and you're tugging on the line. But just one look and you're feeling so fine. And now you're not quite so sure that you don't want to wanna.
Phew, it's like an oven in here. I got us some juice. Do you want sweet melon or do you... Wah.
Thank you, Captain. I believe I am making considerable progress.
Yeah, you're looking, pretty good over there.
You don't wanna, 'cause you just gotta have her now. You know you're a goner, 'cause you know that she's your kind of gal. You've got the infection, she's the cure for your disease. Just one injection, you're begging her, please. Now the only thing you know for sure, yeah, the only thing you know for sure, you're begging her for the cure. 'Cause you really want her.
Oh, Tling! I accidentally hit open instead of the door chime.
It seems you accidentally overrode the lock as well.
Yeah, well, I just wanted to see you, see if you were okay.
We made significant progress on the impulse system, did we not?
Sure, one more day should do it, finish it. But I was talking about you, being such a man, a man. You must have new feelings, new urges. But we couldn't. I'm your superior officer. It would be wrong.
Your pupils are acutely dilated.
Thank you. Wait. Dilated? That's bad, right?
You are experiencing rapid heartbeat as well.
Oh, yes. You should feel it.
Dilated pupils, rapid heartbeat, increased respiration, perspiration, and flushed skin are all symptoms of human sexual arousal.
Arousal? I'm not... Why are you? I mean, I'd understand, but I was... That stuff today, I was just yanking your... jerking, playing with... Fool, kidding. I'm a kidder.
It may have begun that way, but I believe there is something more at work here.
Whoa, hey, cut it! That's an invasion of privacy!
Your symptoms are real, and I believe I know the cause. Pheromones.
Pheromones? What, you mean like those chemical thingies that people supposedly attract mates with? Like in their sweat?
Vulcans do not sweat, but that is the idea.
Wait, Vulcan pheromones? It sounds like a joke.
Perhaps a demonstration of their potency is in order.
Okay.
Okay. Go over there. Shoo!
Phew.
I have been monitoring my altered physiology, and it has remained stable but for an increase in a few significant chemicals, particularly testosterone, and now pheromones. What is more, the pheromones themselves do not seem to be entirely Vulcan in nature, but partly resemble female Orion pheromones.
But wait, Orion women? Their voodoo only works on men. I guess it's their pheromones. They can practically hypnotize a guy, but human women just get a headache. And I do not have a headache.
It would appear that there was far more than vitamins in your vitamin supplement. These increasing pheromone levels concern me, but without a better understanding of this drug, I dare not attempt a counteragent.
You mean this is going to get worse?
Quite possibly.
Okay, I swear I will get that impulse engine rebuilt tomorrow if I have to hold it together with glue and junction tape. And I'll do it alone. I don't need you back there spraying your hormones all over me.
Agreed. In the meantime, I have read that cold showers can help. Stone's Throw Station ahead, Captain.
Finally! I never thought I'd be so happy to see this dump.
Perhaps you have time for another cold...
Let's just find Mud, or whatever he's calling himself now. And he'd better have an antidote, or he'll be getting a new gender.
I have still been unable to ascertain Mr. Mud's exact whereabouts. The crate of bioxin vials I tracked here on Merchnet has yet to be claimed at customs.
Sounds like he's laying low, not just staying off the net.
As the only station he has not visited in Zenarian space, and given his line of work, it is likely that he plans to leave the sector from here.
Right. There are plenty of long-haul ore tugs that could take him even farther from the Federation if he wants. Not to mention all the smugglers that loop in and out of this sector going just about anywhere.
It seems we may need to make inquiries among, shall we say, less savory characters.
Yep. Sometimes you need a scoundrel to find a scoundrel.
Kara Carpenter. Here, let me finish my drink before you start the brawl. And hey, I see you upgraded to a Vulcan dude. Just as well. I never liked that tling. Get chip ice cubes off that girl.
Did you feel that way the time you suggested that we have a little pon far between friends?
How did you...
That is Tling. She took a drug that turned her into a dude.
You two been alone on that ship too long.
It was an accident.
We are looking for this man. He is a wanted criminal in the Federation, a confidence man, and a dealer in illicit goods.
Mud, huh? Yeah, I met him on X1 a while back, but he was calling himself Smith then. He was looking for passage to X2, but I weren't having none of it. I know his type.
And what type is that?
A human in Zenarian space. Ain't no one here from the Federation that ain't running from something.
What are you running from, Mr. Jacobs?
I don't know. What are you running from, Pixie?
Perhaps you could continue about Mr. Mud.
Don't know much else, except you're not the only ones looking for him. That Klingon chip that's been kicking around the sector? They got here probably just after you. And I hear they've been rattling the whole station trying to shake this guy loose.
Krag wants Mud? What for?
Do it matter? Klingon's looking for you, you best not be found. But if you want Mud still breathing, you better find him first.
Well, he can't just lock himself in a hold forever. He has to surface to book passage off the station.
Krag has the advantage of a large crew in any search.
And we only have... Hey! You and your crew makes 5, Jacobs. Go tell them to start asking around at...
Whoa! I ain't getting my crew mixed up with Klingons.
Look, you still owe us for hauling that hulk of yours back to port after you blew your core and almost got us all killed.
All right, don't get your panties in a twist. But after this, we're even.
Well, that's some help. Maybe. The one advantage we have is we know where Mud's cargo is, still in customs. We might find something out there.
Perhaps I should go to the customs office, while you remain here and make further inquiries.
I'll go. I know how to handle those customs flunkies. It takes a little finesse and...
I shall go alone, Captain, while you stay and make inquiries about Mr. Mudd.
Okay.
I spit on your official forms, Cahom! We know you hold the cargo of this harcourt of Fenton Mud. Do not deny it!
I have explained that I will need you to show documented approval by the owner in order to...
Bring us the owner, and I shall get that approval!
You are welcome to petition the customs office by...
Tell us where its owner can be found!
Captain, the Klingons have traced Mr. Mudd's cargo to the customs office. Please respond. Captain!
Yes, I was asking about Mud. I want to find him too. Ow! I can help you.
We need no help from humans.
Ow!
Is this not the same insolent human who maligned our ship at Outreach Station? Perhaps we should take her back to the captain.
Perhaps we should simply take her nose to the captain, since she insists upon poking it where it is not wanted.
Perhaps we can resolve this peacefully.
Toing! I didn't start this one, I swear! Ow!
Sirs, please, unhand my captain.
Please?
Ow!
A real man would not ask, please!
You must excuse me. I am not a real man.
Tling, look out!
Just a little dizzy. I think I can walk.
The ship is not far.
I'm feeling a lot better, but maybe you could stay. To keep an eye on me.
There appears to be no sign of concussion. The pheromone levels in your body are persisting longer than I anticipated, however. Perhaps...
Would you stop analyzing and quantificating for a minute? I feel like I'm going crazy. Like I'm going to explode.
Try to think of something else.
It's not working. You have to help me. Maybe I just need to get this out of my system.
Agreed, Captain.
Really? I mean, oh, okay. Will I need protection?
Absolutely. Undress while I go and get it.
Okay.
Oh, I can't believe you're making me wear a spacesuit.
It is for your own protection.
It's not what I meant, and you know it.
My augmented pheromones are building up in your system faster than your body is metabolizing them. The suit will protect you from further exposure.
Why don't you wear a spacesuit? You're the one spraying hormones.
Pheromones. And we do not have an EV suit in my present size.
We don't have one in my present size either. This thing is riding up my...
You are complaining in your usual manner. The suit may already be working.
I'm sorry, Tling. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
I know, Captain. Vulcan philosophy teaches one not to dwell on speculation.
Could you be happy as a man? You know, Vulcan happy?
It is difficult living a life different from one's true inner nature.
What's that?
A communicator from one of Krag's crew. I have been monitoring their communications.
You speak Klingon?
I understand Klingon. They are ordering all crew to the entertainment level.
They found mud!
Really? This magical potion is only supposed to make men more manly and women more womanly. I didn't know the Klingons. Gentlemen, surely we can come to some arrangement.
Hold still, Shuri. The wager is who can hit the closest to your miserable carcass without drawing blood. But we Klingons are not practiced at missing our targets.
Perhaps we should pin him to the wall to keep him still.
We are too late, Captain. We are far outnumbered.
It's not always about the numbers.
Captain!
Excuse me. Pardon me. Please, don't kill him.
My plucky Pocahontas. My ginger Joan of Arc.
We just need to talk to him first. Then you can kill him.
Busty Benedict Arnold.
Just work with me. This mud is a lowly worm. Hardly worth soiling your mighty dagger blade thingies on, upon. But whatever your anger with this man is, it cannot be as vast as ours. Look at what he has done to my comrade. She was a lovely Vulcan woman until this evil guy's sinister potion turned her into what you see there upon. Hence, before you.
Oh, looks good to me.
Sister? You don't know the half of it. But that's not what she wants. And she's my friend and my crew. I demand custody of Harcourt Mud. We need him to change my friend back. Tell your Captain Krag that I call upon his honor as a fellow captain.
Perhaps you can tell Captain Krag yourself.
Krag?
I tire of your words, and I tire of games. I shall cut the very heart from this Gorvit and feed it to him before he dies for what he has done to me.
Organ meats don't agree with me.
Yeah!
Krag, if you kill him, you'll be stuck too.
The puny human is correct, Captain. We must interrogate this Fenton Mud. It may be your only chance for a cure.
I do not need Fenton Mud. And I desire no cure.
Captain, what are you saying?
You know me. Krag of House Ortak. Veteran of 100 battles. Even now, I could cut any 3 of you into Dark Douche. Yet, for all the honor and glory, after all the blood and death I have seen, I have lately felt there was something missing in my life. For years, I have been seeking a mate to birth my heirs, and this Allura mate was to be my ultimate weapon to conquer the heart of a woman worthy of my seed.
You.
But this change, I take it as a sign that my search is over. that the woman I have been searching for, the woman to bear my children, was destined to be me!
Aw, so after all the death and killing, you just wanted to bring some life into the world.
Life! Pah! I shall bring more warriors into the world! Strong sons and daughters, like me! Birth from my very loins, screaming and bloody, and already fighting for their first breath! They shall be nurtured upon the virtues of power and honor, and together we shall found a dynasty that will rule the Klingon people for 1,000 years! Why did Bevan hit the jet this show?
Drinks for all!
Yes! First we drink! Then we fight! Then we sing!
No, we should leave before that last part. As fine a Vulcan lass as I ever saw.
So, it was that Klingon bite that caused all the trouble?
Partially. By analyzing Mr. Mudd's equipment and processes, I discovered that Alluramate infuses the subject cells with a kind of synthetic chameleoid substrate with Orion properties, which accounts for both the shapeshifting and the aggressive pheromones.
And that Klingon bite...
In Klingon gestation, exposure to an overabundance of either male or female pheromones can cause a fetus to assume the opposite gender, presumably an evolutionary adaptation to maintain gender balance in such a warlike species. I surmise that this gender mutability is somehow reactivated in Klingons by the Alluramate. In the case of Captain Krag, exposure to his male crew members signaled a need for more females. In my case, Klingon DNA in the saliva of that bite reacted with the Alluramate in my system. But where I was exposed to your female pheromones...
You turned into a guy!
Elimination of first the residual Klingon DNA in my system, then the chameleoid substrate, created a reverse cascade, allowing my body to return to its original state. A process somewhat less pleasant than the original mutation.
But you must admit, she was devilishly handsome. You know, between your scientific knowledge, my Vulcan beauty, and your fine ship, my fiery one, we could perfect this elixir of love and sell it from Alpha 3 to Omega 7. It would be riches beyond anything you've... Ugh. Ah, well... You can't blame a man for trying. But can't you find it in your hearts to let me keep my chemical synthesizer? It does have legitimate uses. You're taking away my livelihood.
The galaxy is safer with it in our hands.
And Tling might have a relapse or something. Or we might run across some of your more unhappy customers. Unless you want us to take you around to visit them. I wonder how it affected those Nausicaans you mentioned.
I... really should hurry along. I don't want to miss my departure time.
Come in.
I...
I just wanted to apologize again for this mess and to check on how you're feeling. Are you really all you again?
As far as the scans can determine.
Thank goodness. Don't get me wrong. You made a great guy. But I'm glad to have you back.
Captain, I am curious about one thing. This Aluramate. Its purpose was to make one more attractive to a potential mate, as Captain Crag intended for himself. Do you seek a mate?
Not a mate, exactly. Just growing up, with my past, I wasn't exactly popular with the boys. Not the nice ones. And now I'm just a mech monkey on a freighter, and I spend half my time sweaty and smelly and up to my armpits in machinery. So when I heard about Aluramate, I thought it might be nice to, you know, be irresistible for once. I mean, I couldn't even get you to glance my way. You as a guy, I mean.
Captain, as a man, your attempts at seduction held little appeal for me.
Yeah,
It was at the times when you were just yourself, intelligent, decisive, and capable, that I found you the most alluring.
That's probably the nicest thing a guy almost said to me. You know, Delaney, we could probably make some more of that stuff.
Don't even think about it.
Good night, Tulane.
Good night, Captain.
Coming with the dawn and leaving night behind. I'm losing all my dreams, but bringing us a new day. Take me to a new day. Take me to a new day.